A really easy way to change the format and style of our chart is by using the Chart Styles tool beside it. Let's click on it. There are more than 14 different styles to choose from, with or without labels, different colors, background, and many more. Select this. The second step is to change the color of the columns, and we can do this by clicking this tab called Color. As you see, the two basic sections are colorful and monochromatic. Of course, all features are in Design tab, and as we saw in the previous lectures, here we can make whatever change we want. Examples are changing the style of our chart from Chart Style section, changing colors, the useful Quick Layout button, and of course the Add Chart Element button. Let's change the direction of the legend. Finally, we can choose any type of chart we want from Change Chart Type button, except from XY scatter charts, bubble charts, and stock charts. Click on it and select the 3D cluster bar. If we must create a bubble chart, for example, then we can use a trick. First, click on a cell of pivot table, go to Analyze Chart, press Pivot Table button, then Options, and make sure that the option Generate Get Pivot Data is unchecked. Okay, now click on an empty cell beside the pivot table, type plus, click A1 and enter. Drag all the way down to the right and our clone pivot table is ready. Now we don't have the limitation and we can create bubble, scatter or stock chart. Special highlight that pivot charts have are field buttons. What do I mean by that? Go to Analyze tab, then Field Buttons, and uncheck Hide All. Now look at our chart. There are buttons around it. Press Quarter. We can easily check the first quarter, or we can delete the average of PowerPoint simply by right-clicking on it and remove field. So very useful. Thanks for watching.